Hi there, how are you? I'm Jack Buck, and you're just in time for Top Star Bowling. Why don't you come in and settle down, relax for about an hour, and watch some of the top bowling stars of the world. You'll enjoy it. Come on. It's time for another week of Top Star Bowling. What a dandy we have lined up for you on this session. We're at the Marlboro Lanes in the village of Marlboro, which is just southwest of the city of St. Louis, the gateway to the west. And we have $1,500 in prize money available on this show. In addition, our two bowlers are bowling for an additional $2,500. We'll tell you about that as we go along. And before introducing our bowlers, one of whom is back for the third consecutive week, let me tell you that it's a three-game match. Total pins determine the winner. $1,000 to the winner, and he comes back next week. $500 to the loser. King Louis Shirts has provided $1,500 for the high series and $1,000 for the high game in a particular 13-week period. Let's meet them here now because we have a nice audience on hand and a great match coming up. The first party to be met is from Detroit. He's back for the third time, having defeated two opponents. Billy G is the common name for him. Former Masters champion, great team bowler, great doubles bowler. He's won an awful lot of titles and a lot of money on this show, Billy Golombiewski. Well, good to see you.
Nice to be back.
Another week. How's the traveling between Detroit and St. Louis? Easy, huh?
Well, going by jet, it's real fast.
Mm-hmm. And you've got your hands full today.
I sure have.
People
world's best.
People here I know are anxious to meet a homegrown product, we being in the St. Louis area. The only man ever to win the All-Star title four times, Don Carter. Don, good to see you.
Thank you, Jack.
What are you doing with the glove?
Well, it helps a little, Jack, sometimes.
Well, if you don't get a plug in now, you never will.
You're right.
I'll take care of that up there, Don. Right, we'll just give you the handshake, and away we go.
Fine. Good luck. Good luck, Billy.
There they are, folks. Billy G. Billy G and Don Carter. Three games, total pins, Top Star Bowling. Don Carter won the toss, and he elected to follow Billy G and be on lane 22. So here's our start. This is not a practice toss, although Billy G wishes it were. Alongside me is Jerome Whitey Harris, a member of the Brunswick Advisory Staff of Champions, as are Billy Golombiewski and Don Carter. And you'll be enjoying Whitey's comments as we go along with this match. It's the third week for Golombiewski. Defeated Al Thompson, Chuck Wagner. We've got Don Carter to contend with now, and he spares in the first frame. Top Star Bowling is sanctioned by the American Bowling Congress. The lane conditions are certified by the ABC. We're about to watch the unique style of Don Carter. He's playing way inside. And he carries a strike. And a sly grin creeps across his face. Whitey, he wasn't directly in front of me. I couldn't see the hit, but judging from everything, it wasn't too good.
No, it was actually a wild pitch, and I think this is one of the rare times that you've ever seen Don Carter over on the Brooklyn.
Mm-hmm. And no 10-pin as he's going for the double. Whitey, you might tell us about that very attractive bowling ball that Don is employing.
Don is using the Gold Crown ball, and it's one of the balls developed by the Brunswick Company. Actually, that gold appearance, that's 23-karat gold that's flecked around that inner surface of the ball.
Don got stuck a little bit there at the approach, but carried his spare, giving him 20 in the first frame with a spare up. Billy G. had a spare. They're shooting at high series and high game for additional money. strike for Billy Golombevsky. The high series so far is owned by Golombevsky with a 646. And we doubt that that will last for very long. Billy's from Detroit. He also has the high single 235, by the way. Won a lot of doubles titles with Joe Joseph. ABC Masters champion twice. And a double. A spare and then a double, and Don Carter comes up on 22. Don is from St. Louis. Born and raised in this area, always has lived here. And you heard what Billy G said when I introduced him. He said, the greatest in the world. I wasn't going to press it out there and perhaps embarrass either one of the bowlers, but that's what the other bowlers think of him. He was over in the Brooklyn before, and he's on the head pin again, checking his condition at the foul line. After releasing the ball, he leaves at 3-6-10, so Billy G is out in front with a double.
Don, like all the professional bowlers on this 3-6-10, Jack, he stands to the left of the approach, and he'll walk directly towards that three pin. I think, like you started to comment, Jack, if any one man has ever done anything for a professional bowling, it was Don Carter who was able to reach the heights he had, and as a result, he brought the game up. Anything new on the young lady? She's here again today.
Well, I know she's enjoying watching Don Carter. I don't know. Her name is Isbell. I know she's here for every show.
You know what? I'm going to get up enough nerve. I think I'm going to find out a little bit more about her.
I already have, and I'm not going to tell you. Thin hit didn't carry as Billy was going for three in a row. So spare, a double, and now he has to bring back the 2-4-5-8. Carries. He is a little bit fearful of that five pin, but he spares in the fourth frame. Mr. G was voted King of Detroit Bowlers for quite a few years. Bowling Magazine, All-American Team, Bowlers Journal Team, National Bowling Illustrated All-American Team. He's one of the best. And a strike with a thin hit and a good driving ball, giving him 86 through the fourth with a strike up. Now, Billy has the only double of this match, and he has three strikes. Don has two strikes as he bowls in the fifth, and he's going for his first double. Now, this is a lane where he has missed twice, although he did carry a strike. He had that ball driving in there beautifully for the double. Both of these bowlers, each of these bowlers using a different approach. Billy outside, coming up with that hook, and Don staying inside. The ball not running very much for him. He's looking for a three-bagger now. And, nope. Six pin remains. Only three games, and total pins count. The winner will come back and be here again with us next week.
Dean Cutrade will be the next bowler, Jack. He's from around the New Orleans area, one of their top bowlers.
And the spare. More and more, you find the good bowlers from various portions of the country. It used to be to Detroit, Chicago, St. Louis, New York City, L.A., but since that time, boy, you find them every place.
Well, different things, like Top Star Bowling has brought bowling into a lot of areas, Jack, and these young people get an opportunity to see these stars, and that's the usual thing. Once you get to let people see stars, they copy their form and everything else.
1-2-10 for Billy G. Has to get over on the Brooklyn side as he bowls in the sixth frame. This match is precisely even at the moment. If Billy G can cover this. And he didn't. So there's the first open of the match, and Don Carter goes out in front. Billy G up in the seventh frame. And no five pin. It's unusual that ball wouldn't carry the five pin. He's starting so far out and throwing right for their pocket.
Looks like he did give the ball the usual push Billy has been doing with the ball, you know, getting it pointed towards the 1-3 pocket.
Even on this five pin, you'll see where he delivers the ball. He'll throw his regular strike ball to try to cover this five pin. And he'll check the rotation of that ball, make use of the information the next time he comes up over there on 21. Now Don Carter, with a spare, is bowling in the seventh frame.
Don will note, I will, Jack, has changed his style in the last 2 years. If you'll notice where the ball is, he holds it a little to the right.
That's
comparable
Ray.
To Ray Blue style.
Mm-hmm. Three guys a strike. Don Carter has won the World's Invitational 5 times. The BPAA All-Star 4 times. The Seattle Open, the Eastern Open, Houston Open, Tucson Open, Rochester Open, National Open.
You sound like you're in a railroad station master giving out the calls when you read off this fella's record.
A high hit carries. I'm going to get one of those gold crown jewels myself.
I think the advertising reads, Jack, that it's miracle tracking power. Well, that certainly was a miracle hit. Did you notice Don smiling to himself when
I think
the
ball
back?
Spreads out when it hits something. Billy G in the eighth frame with a spare out. Leaves a 6-7. After opening in the sixth with a miss, he now has a split in the eighth while Don Carter has been carrying his hits, and Don has compiled 5 strikes, putting together 2 doubles. And Carter has opened a lead. It'll do him a lot of good to get this one. He's got a real crack at it. He needed that the way Carter's been carrying, and he got it. And now the ninth frame, and he'll try to get on one to set it up for the roll-off.
It just I had the opportunity. I was going to explain how to pick that,
but
and I failed again.
Okay. Ninth frame, and they're dropping late for him, but they're all dropping. And that's the 7-pin that toppled over and gives Billy the 4th strike of the game. Don Carter into the 9th frame now, looking for 3 in a row. Had a double earlier and then left the 6-pin. Let's see what he does with this opportunity. 2 former Masters champions battling here on Top Star Bowling. And no 10-pin. I suppose Golombieski was happy to see that that double wasn't going to turn into a string of 6. Takes the 10-pin, spares in the 9th frame. 175 through the 8th for Don, and he comes up in the 10th frame. 225 if he can hit 3. $1,000 up for grabs.
Notice how he rushes the foul line, Jack? This is a good tip for a lot of your bowlers.
There's the strike. How he rushes the foul line.
No, often the different riders have tagged different ways that he goes to the foul line, and one of the ones I think that really applies to it, they said it looks like an Indian creeping up to the foul line with that little tippy toe.
Don has 6 strikes in this game. It seems that he is capable of carrying more hits in different fashions than other bowlers.
Well, I think one of the reasons, Jack, he doesn't put a lot actually on the ball. He's so accurate that he's right in range of the pocket as close as you can be, I mean, to getting a strike. That's why his light hits carry.
He'll carry
very
the
effective
thin hits,
ball.
Carry the high hits. And he did not carry there.
What a good place to leave that as down ends with 224.
Billy G has a strike working for him in the ninth, fortunately for him. He cannot catch Don Carter. That open in the sixth frame prevents that. And no seven pin, no double. Brings that back to again 172, and 192 is his high potential. Hence, he'll be 32 pins behind. You don't want to get too far behind Mr. Carter. Nor does Don want to get too far behind Billy. There's the spare. 4-172.
Jack, I think earlier you commented about the high game in regards to Billy G, high single and high three.
Mm-hmm. 646, 235. That's what Carter is shooting at.
So there's a 20 count in the 10th frame, and Billy G ends with 192. Don Carter, 224. Here on Top Star Bowling with Billy G and Don Carter, we're watching two different styles, two different approaches to the pocket. Very interesting match. Don Carter had seven strikes in the first game. Billy G had five, and Billy had the games only open, hence the difference of 32 pins as we get set for the second game here at the Marlboro Lanes.
Billy was the leadoff man in the first game, so now Don Carter will start the second. Leading 224 to 192. Right over the second arrow, thin hit 245. The most amazing aspect of Don Carter's bowling is the last instant control that he has on that bowling ball. He is fully extended out over the foul line and still has control of the ball. Hence, he is able to change speeds more readily than most bowlers, able to adjust to lane conditions. It's one of the big reasons why he has been the champion that he has been. If the average bowler could hang onto that ball as long as Don could, they'd put 20 pins to their average, Whitey.
That's true, Jack, and we keep... I guess the folks wonder why we constantly point out that these bowlers have such follow-throughs. I think most of these champions that we do have on the show, it's follow-through that's what helps them.
Billy's a good example of it here, and I notice that he is not doing here what he usually does. That is a big follow-through with the thumb pointing to the ceiling here.
That could be the reason why he hasn't been able to put those strikes together just now.
He's going for the two-pin. So each has a spare here in the first frame of the second game. Billy G from Detroit. Don Carter from St. Louis, each a former Masters champion. Battling for survival here with a lot of money at stake.
See, he got that follow through that time, Whitey. He got that arm way out, the thumb up in the air, and the ball right in the pocket and gets his strike.
It looked like, Jack, when he was at the top arc, almost like our arch on the riverfront there, he was snapping his finger, his thumb and finger.
Carter with a spare up, trying to match that strike.
Beautifully in the pocket.
Did you ever see anybody try to copy Don's style?
I did, Jack.
You saw somebody, or you tried to copy it?
No, I tried to copy, and that's why I'm back here. No, this goes along, Jack, that as an individual, you must use whatever you have, and Don just used his style, and he, through constant practice.
He was hoping for a getaway only. He wasn't hoping for a strike there, and he did get away as he leaves the six pin.
Jack, and speaking of practice, and we know that in all fields, the fellas that are tops are the ones that put the most into it, and I think this is an example of a champion that was really made because he practiced, he had the desire,
And with that, why he was able to accomplish so many things he did.
There's the spare. Don is a former professional baseball player. He's an outstanding golfer. And his athletic ability is clearly demonstrated on the lanes. They say you don't have to be an athlete to bowl, but if you enjoy bowling, and you are an athlete, you're that much further ahead. Billy G, beautifully in the pocket. That may be the start of a string for him as he gets his double. Takes away 10 of that 32-pin lead that Don Carter had.
Did you see, notice on the reference to Billy's career that in one season, Jack, he rolled a 228 average. So Billy has many accomplishments also.
Has a high series of 826. 5-7. He was doing a little prancing up there on the approach, knowing that the hit wasn't too good. Don Carter, with a start of 224, has a pretty fair crack at Billy G's high series of 646.
Beautiful.
In the first game, he picked the 6-7, and here he picks the 5-7. And those two recoveries keep him right in the game.
Jack, that was a beautiful shot. I'm sure it was caught on camera, and that system was developed by Joe Norris, where they catch that shot from the rear.
There's Laverne Carter, wife of Don, quite a bowler in her own right, and she will be seen in a future week here on Top Star Bowling against Joy Abel. Laverne, a very personable lady, outstanding bowler, as you know, and that will be a worthwhile session on Top Star Bowling.
She's also doing a lot of instructing work, Jack, in our Learn to Bowl programs.
Each has a spare in the fourth frame. The double by Billy G has picked up 10 pins for him in this game. He's ahead by 10. But he's still down by 22 pins overall. This is the fifth frame for Carter. Carter's been able to avoid those splits. His wife is a real moaner and groaner.
Jack, she certainly is, and you ought to see at some of the top tournaments where Don is involved in the
tournament. She works herself into a frenzy.
That's true, yeah. She reacts very well, and she's always out there pushing for Don to come in with the big one.
He's trying to spare here in the fifth. And there it is. We're in the second game of our three-game match at the Marlboro Lanes. In the village of Marlboro, which is just beyond the city limits of the city of St. Louis.
On Highway 66.
That tells the story. And a strike for Billy, and so Don Carter has 77 through the fourth with a spare up, and Billy G has 88 through the fourth with a strike up. Kolumbievsky has picked up 11 pins in this game. Trails by 21, trying to double.
He only trails by 11. Down on one knee.
Looked like a surveyor.
He was really rooting for that one. Don Carter now in the sixth frame, trying to get on a strike. He has seen his lead dwindle to 11 pins. He was ahead by 32. Don can't find that strike. Directly behind the two bowlers as they are seated here, Billy G and Don Carter, are three members of the St. Louis Cardinal professional football team. As you look, the gentleman on the right is Don Owens. In the middle, Ken Gray. There's the spare.
Did you make a comment that the loser was supposed to wrestle one of these fellas, Jack?
Yeah, but I'd have to take on that winner, so I better not do it. Herb Goody is the third member of the party. Still no strike for Diane, and remember, Billy G has a double going. The young lady will be presenting the prize money later on, so she's enjoying the match here.
Jack Fritz Bugle's sitting here. He'd like to have his name mentioned every once in a while, too.
Carter going for a spare. And he gets it. Billy G has 88 through the fourth with a double working. Don Carter has 113 through the sixth with a spare up. Don Carter is still ahead in the match despite the double which Billy G has going for him. Here in the seventh frame, he's looking for three. And right in there. And now the match is just about even. That's the first three-bagger. Don Carter had three doubles in the first game. Billy G has had a double and a three-bagger in this game, and Don Carter has had only one strike, so he's lost the line. Billy appears to be in a groove. And if the high hit stopped him as he leaves the 6-10. And that'll keep the match even until somebody else, or until somebody does something else. Don Carter bowled 224 in the first game, and Billy Golombievsky 192. It was a 32-pin lead, but Bill has taken care of that. And now he spares. Bill had the match is only open in the first game. Carter has marked in every frame. Billy G is ahead by a pin right now. One pin. Don hasn't been in that pocket for a while. And he leaves the four pin. Has been carrying on that left side, left a couple of four sevens, and now four pin. So Billy G is two pins ahead. Two pins is the difference. After eight frames in the second game. Talking to the bowlers, the conclusion of the first game, and a few of them appear to be sticking up there, but they both seem to agree that it's perspiration that is causing it. So that's why you see Don mopping his brow quite often. He never did get up there. But Whitey, when you stick up there, no matter what the cause, a couple of times it gets to be a mental thing.
Yes, and I thought maybe at that time Don was capable, and they have that last-minute flick of the wrist. I thought he was going to bring it in that.
Going for his spare on the 2-4-5, and he runs by the 5-pin, and that's his first open. And he knew it, too. He knew he was going to do it. So Billy G, who was down 32 pins at the end of the first game against Don Carter, suddenly finds himself out in front. And now look what happens. Now look what happens. It's a 4-7-10. Didn't look that bad to me.
No, it just rode high, Jack. This is one of those I don't want it, you take it matches.
Boy, it's amazing how often that happens in bowling. One fellow strikes, the other comes back and gets one. One fellow opens and his opponent does the same thing. He came very close. Previously, he had picked the 6-7. He also picked the 5-7 previously. But now he opens in the ninth frame. 192 through the ninth. Needs three for 222. There's the first one. Got good action to take down that 5-7 and give him the strike.
Brunswick Skorkins, there was a couple of them laying on the pin deck even as the sweep came through, Jack, so he really did have sweeping action.
We might have a difference of only one or two pins when the second game is over. That's two of them, Paul. So after starting with 192, Billy's going to end with 220-something, 222 if he hits again. Now, the best Don Carter can do after that ninth frame, open, and miss, is 188. Ah, he didn't reach the 220 mark. 219. For Billy G, 411. Don needs some strikes here to make this an even match. Carter could be ahead by a pin if he hits them all. One pin.
Pretty close.
Needs three. Walked away. Walked away, so he's going to trail when this one is over as he leaves the 4-6-10, and he'll just go for the two pins and forget it and hope that the third game will do better by him.
Yeah, he's standing to the left, Jack. The 6-10 is the two pins he's going for.
He gets into a nine count in the 10th frame. Had something to say to Billy G. 167, Billy G, 219. So Golombieski with 411 has a lead over Don Carter, who has 391, a 20-pin difference at the end of the second game.
Only a 20-pin difference as we await the start of the third and final game here on Top Star Bowling. With me on the approach is Don Owens, who is a star defensive player for the St. Louis Cardinal football team. We've mentioned his buddies Ken Gray and Irv Goody are here. And Don, we look like before and after up here, don't we?
Somebody is talking about Geritol. Who are they referring to?
I don't know. You enjoyed the match so far?
Very much, very much. I'm quite impressed by this bowling.
I know that you're a bowler yourself. We've had the pleasure of being together a few times.
Well, I think I do it more for recreation.
I bet you like to hit things that don't hit back once in a while.
Huh? Wouldn't I? Can you see me going home with a sore thumb and getting nursed?
How do you hold that ball?
Really, I don't know.
What's your average, Don?
Oh, about one. Well, I'm over 100. What do you have to push things for?
I'm standing here wondering how you can weigh twice as much as Golombieski and bowl half as much.
A third.
And how about your buddies here? They bowl?
Well, we bowl in the off season a little and get together, the wives and the, you know, the husbands have a little liquid refreshments and bowl a little. And we have some very good bowlers. Irv's got a real good move. Start, stumble, and fall to the line, and we go on like that, but we enjoy it.
Don Owens, I know that you have some children. You ever take the kids bowling?
No, but they take Dad bowling quite a bit. They
I mean, they take you to the cleaners when you bowl, huh?
Well, they take me to the cleaners whether we're bowling or not, but they enjoy it. They have a good time with it. My wife bowls. And,
any prediction on the outcome of this match here?
No, I don't make predictions in anything, unless you weren't reading the paper last year, but no, but I think it's going to be a real good match. I'm quite impressed with it.
We'll enjoy it, and Don, a pleasure to have had you and your friends
Thank
here.
Thank you, Jack. Thank you very much.
Don Owens, our guest. Billy G trailed at the end of the first game. Now he's out in front, and here's the third and final game on Top Star Bowling. Billy G is our leadoff man in the third game. And no way to start when you have a 20-pin advantage. There goes 10 of it right there, Whitey.
Yeah, these are the things that even matches up like this, Jack. And you can bet Don's sitting back there figuring out that the best thing, the way to get this over is start striking.
Each had a split in that second game. Carter had his in the 10th frame. Billy with a nine count. Now Don Carter on 22. Don had only one strike in the second game. That's unusual. Seven in the first game. Billy G had five and then seven. Still can't find it as he leaves the six pin. However, a spare will cut the lead in half. Don Carter from St. Louis.
Jack, it'll be interesting on this next pitch of Don's to see how the Brunswick A2 reacts by the time he gets over to the left lane if the ball is back.
There's his spare. By the time he gets back over, goes to the towel, dries his hand for just an instant, back is the ball, ready to go whenever he wishes.
That type of action is good for bowlers because it keeps them in the groove, Jack, so that they constantly have that rhythm which you'll see right now in the greatest.
There he is. Shaking his head and saying it's about time, so he picked up 11 pins in that first frame. And he's down by 9. Billy G ahead by 9, trying to get on a strike. He was pretty much in the groove with 7 strikes in the second game. He was way out and thin, 2-4-5.
Be interesting, Jack, to see where Billy stands. If he stands to the right of the approach, or if he stands right even with this 2-4-5, and that's what he's doing.
There's his strat. Three's on a mark after an open. Now Don Carter can again take the lead when he comes up there. You're watching two fellows, both of whom have been named to numerous All-American teams. If you were to name the top 10, you'd have to include both of these men, no matter what order you place them. 4 pin. When you get up to that upper strata of bowlers, why, it's pretty tough to point out number 1 and 2. And we've had some of the good ones here in Top Star Bowling and others to appear in the future weeks. Dean Coutrade will be here next week. Al Savas, Bob Strampy, Tom Hennessy, Dick Hoover. You name them, you'll see them on Top Star Bowling. There's the spare for Billy J. Now Carter in the third frame with a strike up. He was inside the second arrow. He's been playing right over that second arrow. Results in the 4-7-9 and... Not only will it likely end in an open, but he missed a chance for a double.
Jack depicted as Don is studying. He'll stand to the right on the approach, go to the left of the 4 pin, which is the closest pin to him, and try to slide the 4 over to the 9.
Well, he came very close. Very, very close. With an 8 count. So each has had an open. Billy G has regained his advantage. He's about 22 pins ahead right now. This is the 4th frame of our last game. Carter has hit that one twice. The 8 pin was pretty late in dropping, but it fell for him.
Jack, you commented earlier, we did, on the gold crown ball. Actually, the ball that Billy is using is a crown jewel. Both these bowling balls have what is called the miracle tracking action.
It's too bad the show is not in color. You could appreciate it. There's a strike. You could appreciate these items a little more, including the decor of the lanes here at Marlboro. Each has a strike working in the 4th frame. Billy G has added 2 pins to his lead. He's ahead by 22. Who's going to double? That 4 pin. I think he was high enough in that pocket that he couldn't have complained too much if he didn't carry that 4 pin, but he got it in a big double. Carter has to stay with him. And he leaves the 3-10. The baby split for Carter. His second split of this game. Billy G appears to be on his way for his third $1,000 prize. Carter got it. Billy G, 48 through the third with a double up. Don Carter has 66 through the fourth with a spare. Three strikes on 21 for him, so the one main is bothering him. Billy G has a double for this most important delivery of the contest right here.
I would say so, Jack, because we're at the halfway point, and especially for Billy.
Looking for 3.
much.
Carter's going to have a devil of a time catching him now.
Billy, with that follow-through at the end, should remind your guests of what is called a fair catch, isn't it, in football?
Mm-hmm.
They raise that hand up there?
That's the signal.
And I guess that's what's in Billy's mind. He wants to catch all those pins.
Looking for four. Where in the world did that nine-pin come from? That nine-pin gives Carter a chance. Don is able to hit the one lane, which he hasn't been able to hit in this game. Billy G was ahead by 20 pins at the start of this last game. He's really bearing down on this nine pin. And he spares, gives him 127 through the six with a spare up. Carter has to start a string right here. He can't find the 22 at all. 2, 4, 5, 8. This is the seventh frame for Carter. Can't afford to open here. That would do it. And the 8 pin. So Don Carter has had his problems here. He was probably considered the favorite when this match started. There's 114 through the seventh. Golombieski has opened up a 42-pin lead. And now Don can't hit the lane, which has been kind to him, as he comes up with a 4-6-10. Billy G could go on to a 237. Carter takes down the 610. He opens again in the eighth frame. Has 123 through the eighth. Boy, you won't see Carter roll many series any lower than this. Golombieski could bowl 237 and beat his own high of 235. The four pin stops him, giving him 146 through the seventh. All he has to do is keep marking here and he'll be all right.
Yes, by keeping clean, Jack, it would put too much of a... Well, I think we'd run out of frames.
Spare for Billy in the eighth.
I think Billy knows this, too, and of course we always say there's no defensive action in bowling here. They're always trying to get strikes. So it'll be interesting to see if he's going right for that head pin, which he has been having trouble on this lane.
He's in his ninth frame. He didn't get to the head pin.
I would like to, and we'll remember, we'll ask him if he didn't play that safe.
Yeah.
It'd be an interesting point because I know this is brought up a lot of time, whether they do play safe.
I'll ask him when this is all over. And now he spares. It would be a wise approach because he had no chance to rack up a high series or a particularly high game. Don Carter in the ninth frame now. He's there. It's the one he couldn't hit before.
Storytelling time, Jack. Even as we're closing out, you know, Mom Carter here is... Don's mother is here, and she is collects all of Don's trophies, and she actually has a room that was built onto her home just to take care of all the trophies that this guy's won.
The 310 in the 10th frame. Don doesn't take kindly to performances like this on his part.
No, I think it's the difference. It's such a sharp match, Jack. And where this guy's the greatest is when it's a long run, like the 100 games and things like that. He'll admit that. It's nothing against his ability.
He opens again. He had four opens in that game. And he ends with 151. And And a 542. Billy G on a spare. That's a strike. The bell's going to be in the 600s. Going to be down by about 80 pins. This will be his third consecutive win, and Dean Coutrade will be his opponent next week. Money piles up in a hurry if these bowlers can hit him. Here's the 4-7. One more delivery coming for him. 204 if he takes these two down. And 615. This will be Billy's third 600 series. 204 for Billy Golombiewski, 615, a winner over Don Carter, who had 542. Chance to visit with the bowlers here at Marlboro on Top Star Bowling before awarding the prize money. And Billy, congratulations to you once again.
Thank you.
For the third week. And Don, what's the opposite of congratulations? Don, Whitey and I pointed out before that the sort of matches that you come to the fore in are usually those with 100 games and so forth in the invitation. Out here in these three games, you either have it or you don't, right?
And I didn't have it, Jack.
This one lane bothered over you.
Oh, actually, and it wasn't the one lane. Both of them, I threw about 8 balls in a row right on the nose, Jack. I just couldn't get out of the ball freely. I couldn't go straight through it. I kept overturning, dumping the ball, and my footwork was bad. The last game, I was afraid to pick up the ball.
One of the few times I've seen you unable to adjust to the situation.
Yeah, the conditions, when I threw the ball right, I could strike. It's the first game, I threw a few pretty good balls, but that was the end of it. And I know they didn't change, you know.
Billy, another getaway. You didn't bowl as well as you can bowl, either.
No, I threw a lot of bad balls today. I had 4 or 5 splits there. I was pretty fortunate, though. I converted a couple of them, so that helped out.
It did make a big difference.
It sure did.
Whitey and I were wondering up there in the 9th frame of the last game when you just had a mark and stayed clean and win it, were you playing it safe when you didn't come up to the head pin?
No. I just threw the ball a little too wide is all I did.
You didn't mind too much, though, did you?
Well, no. After all those splits, I'd rather be light anyway.
You made sure you weren't going to cross over.
Well, I didn't want another hole.
Well, that's what I mean by playing it safe. That's what you
mean. Yeah, I did throw it out a little bit, but...
I'd make a good lawyer. I'd make a good lawyer, huh, Don?
You got it out of him, Jack.
That's what he was doing, isn't it?
Evidently. It didn't make much difference at that point.
Well, let's take care of the money aspect of things right now. We have a young lady who's a graduate of the John Robert Power School of Modeling and the Pat Allen Agency here in St. Louis. Donna Stemme is the money gal this particular week. Donna, you want to move right in here, please?
Yes. Don, this is your check for $500, and congratulations, Billy. Yours for $1,000.
Thank you very kindly.
Thank you.
Well, she did that in a hurry, didn't she?
Yeah.
We've been with him on better days, and I'm sure that there'll be other big checks coming his way. And Don, nice to have had you here. Good to see Laverne. Maybe she'll bring home the big money of the family then.
I hope so. And she has to vote better than I did, Jack.
And good, sure. And good to see your mom here, too.
Fine.
For this show.
Thank you very kindly.
One of the best, folks, Don Carter. You're knocking him off 1, 2, 3.
Well, I hope to make it 4. We'll try.
Got a fellow from New Orleans coming up.
Dean Coutrade. Mm-hmm. Yes, I've bowled against him many times. He's a real nice bowler.
And we'll see you back here at Marlboro next week.
Sure will.
Take it easy in Detroit for a while.
There you go.
So Billy Golombiewski wins again here in Top Star Bowling, and next week we'll be back here at the Marlboro Lanes, which is in the village of Marlboro, just outside the city limits of the city of St. Louis on Route 66. We'll have more Top Star Bowling and another match for $1,000. Speaking for Whitey Harris, Jack Buck says, thanks for your time this time. Till next time, so long. Bowling equipment by Brunswick, the number one name in bowling. Top Star Bowling is sanctioned by the American Bowling Congress.